first, everyone is talking about this. This is the official trailer for Prince Harry and Meghan's bombshell 6-part documentary. I mean, settle in till January, folks. And it's time to hear what we think.
Wow.
No one sees what's happening behind the closed doors. Do everything I could to protect my family.
When the stakes were this high, doesn't it make more sense to hear our story from us?
Judy, you were literally licking your lips there.
Wow, somebody's about to spill the tea. Oh my God.
Nadia, what did you think?
Well, I watched it last night, and I have to be honest, when I first started watching, I got goosebumps. Mm. I think it's an astonishing trailer that's cut down. There's a really interesting moment where you see Meghan crying and then it cuts to a photograph of Kate looking sort of very angry, but nothing, you know, not connected. I think she's in Westminster Abbey. And so you look at that and you think, wow, this has been approved, this trailer, and this trailer is saying, we're going for it now. I would like to say I wouldn't watch anything so awful, but I can't wait. I'm going to get popcorn. I'm going to be juiced. Because, and don't forget,
but this is
they've done a deal
lives.
For over 100 million smackaroonies. 110 smackaroonies. Yeah. So you've got to give some.
I know.
You've got to give.
Who would have done it? Say that again, Judy.
110
million.
Not just for this, they have other deals. But that means we're going to get some juicy.
Oh, it doesn't.
Stuff. Don't you think?
Do you know what? I'm not even looking for anything juicy. I just want to see, like, their house, their garden. Yeah. Who does the night feed?
Like Housewives of Beverly Hills or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
An
What's
observational documentary. I'm very excited for them. Good for them.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think the royal family's going to be that excited, though, are they? I mean, I wonder what conversation's going on down there when they see that being released. Do you think they'll be worried?
Well, I think I would be worried. Wouldn't you be worried? But I do think, and I've said this before, I think it's a shame because I think they probably left very angry and hurt when they left and probably people came in and said, you can earn all this money. I always think it's best to sit on something for a bit before, but this deal was signed so quickly. Yeah, I wonder if any part of
September 2020, I think they signed the deal for this. And there's been a lot of water under the bridge and obviously it'll be a long time in the making.
I think maybe that when you're hounded that much by the press, I do think you instinctively just want to write a proper right of reply. So I don't know how I would feel if I was constantly felt like my character was being defamated. And, you know, I was being dragged through a narrative.
But it's the media. The royal family haven't actually said anything.
But she might just...
But it might be just about the media.
But they might Harry and Meghan might just
find
be
out next week
in the media. They might not even answer anything. It might just be a really nice, like...
What would you want to hear? Because you want to see the house and all the night sort of pillows.
Yeah, who does what? Who drives? Yeah. You know what I mean? I just want to know who drives.
Do you want to spend more time with the chickens in the hutch?
Yeah.
I just think, look, you know, everyone says about them, you know, whether it's going to affect the family. There's already ripples in the family. There's been ripples in the family for years before they even got married. So they haven't been able to speak, as they'd say, their truth in that sense. And I'm not saying it's not when I do that. I just mean, like, I mean that in the sense of people saying, oh, they're speaking their truth. Mm. They want to say their side. At the end of the day, whether it's the media or whether the silence from the royal, there's been kind of... a suggestion put out of what Meghan is like and how she's manipulated Harry and all this other stuff.
Do you think she got to say that on Oprah, though?
No, I just, you know what? I feel like it doesn't matter what interview she does, what book she sells, what Netflix she show that she does, there's always going to be some kind of negative connotation because for some reason people don't like her or they feel like she didn't fit in. And I think what people are uncomfortable about is that they might bring up the conversation, which has been had so many times, about racism, whether it's in the royal or racism within the UK.
Well, do you know what I hope? I hope if they do discuss the racism, and I think that they should, I think they should give us the actual story of what happened because I think it's really important that we know it.
But look at it, for example, everyone is so going over the fact that they've got this Netflix show, but no one's not talking about that. The police have confirmed that she had threats to her life which were really disturbing.
I'm sure they'll probably talk about all
But that, even in the media now, is not being put out there as much as is about the Netflix. But look, let's keep it real. We're all here for the juice and we want to see it. No matter what. No, we never like seeing the family come into this part where, you know, there's such destruction within it. But, you know, they've got their story and this is how they choose to
hold
their
and he wants to
protect his wife.
I love reality shows and Bacon saying this isn't a reality show.
But it is.
And it's fixed part. You can't say it's not a reality show, can you?
I guess that's what makes me feel a bit uncomfortable, because there is a lot of, oh, we want the juice, we want the juice, we want to see it. But, I mean, these are real lives. You know, there she is. Look at that photograph. You know...
Stunning, isn't it?
Would you do it, Kay, though? If someone said, here's 110 million...
No.
Can we do an observational documentary on your life?
Well, God, you wouldn't get 110 million.
£1.10,
yeah, you'd be lucky. It's just not my way, you know?
No.
I'm not in any way judging them, because obviously they're in a completely different situation from me, but I'm just not that person. Even watching the trailer makes me feel uncomfortable, because I think, what is going to happen? Are they going to let off a bomb that is going to cause, you know, havoc that they're just not going to be able to get
back
in?
That's
the answer.
Can it get any worse?
But if they will have thought that through, they're clearly very smart people. They will have gone through all of the permutations.
Cool, they'll be going for their £110 million bags.
Like Scrooge McDuck.
Yeah, well...